Hi guys! Today I'm going to show you how you can get your drill pin like this one to look like this one with seed beads. So that is what I'm going to show you guys today, how to do this so you can decorate your own drill pen. And something I really like with it is that the seed bead actually does so the pen is going to be thicker. So I actually like how it lay in the hand now, and also that it's thicker than the original pen that we get. So, yeah, let's get started. I will just put those to side. And here, on the note, I just wrote down what you guys need. You need some seed beads, size 9. And needle, size 10. And some thread. And that's it. And then of course a drill pen, but those we get a lot of, so we have plenty of drill pens to do this with. So let's get started. I took about 2 arm lengths of thread. It will not be enough, but I will show you guys what to do when we get up where we don't have enough thread left. And yeah, I will show you guys, so don't worry. So let's get started. To start with, I will take 15 seed beads on the needle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So here we have 15 beads on the thread. So what we are ouch! I poked myself. So what we are going to do now is to make a circle. Also make sure that you have some thread hanging out here in the end, and we need that to secure the beads when we're done. So now we're going to make a circle. So what you do is you're going into the first one. But actually what I'm going to do, because you can see they move easily around on the thread, so what I'm going to do is I'm going through them all again, because it will make the ring a little bit more tidy so it don't go up for you guys. So just go through them all and you will be okay. So and two ones, and then into the first one. There we go. So here we have the circle. So now you take Actually, there is something I'm going to tell you guys is that today I'm actually trying to make the stripes a little bit more wider than this one. So if you want to make it look like the one that I have made, you just change between the colors. Just take one and you will be okay. But here today I'm going to make some wider stripes. So I'm going to take two times of the same color. So, yep. And we're starting with this one. Take one seed bead on and jump over one seed bead into the next one. Then one seed bead, jump over one into the next one. Then change color. One, jump over one into the next one. The same color, jump over one seed bead into the next one. I hope you guys can see what it is I'm doing, because yeah, it is little to sit with. So one seed bead of the other color now, jump over one into the next one. Jump over one into the next. And then back to the purple one. The last ones. Jump over one into the next one. One, but here with the last one we can't jump over one because we only have 15 beads in the circle, and if it had to be correctly there should be 16, but if we put one more bead in the circle it will be too big for the drill pen. So what we're going to do now is we are not going to jump over anybody, but we are going to go into the first one where we started and then up in the first one. Little bit, because we want it to start to be tight. So then it should be looking like this. So now we start, because now that it's going to be much more easy and you can see where we're going. So now one seed bead on with the orange one into the single seed bead and one more into the single. And pull a little bit, then one purple into the purple. Into the single one. over to the other color again. Two times. And then pull the thread a little bit. And then one more into the purple. Purple color into the single one. Oops. And one more. And then we've done with this round. And always go into the first one that you started with. And then up in the first one that we started with. So always when you finish a round, go into the first one that you started with and up in the first one. Okay? So far so good. So I think I will just take the drill pen now and put the work on the drill pen already, because it will make it much more easy. So, and make sure that the thread that we have here in the end is pointing out. So, we just had to press a little bit to get it on here. Did I make it too tight, maybe? It will come. Just press a little bit. Maybe I did make it too tight. As I said, it is the first time. Oh, there we got it on. There we have it. Because now it will just be so much more easy to do when the work is on the drill pen. So what you're doing now is the same thing. Take one into the single seed bead. One again of the same into the purple. I'm sorry guys if you can hear the ambulance. Then the purple one. Into the single one. Oops. My thread is just teasing me a little bit there. That's sadly something that can happen, that I want to come and nut on it, but don't you worry, you can get it out easily and tidy. And then the orange one. And this is just what you keep doing, repeating every round. Just one seed bead on and into that single one on the row that you started on, and then over treble again. And always remember, now we are here at the end. So I take the last seed bead on, go into the one where we started, and then up in the first one. And this is just what you're doing every single round. Just keep doing that when you go to the end. Go into the first one from where you came from and started, and then up in the first one. And then every round you come, just pull the thread, because we... Hi again, guys. Yeah, my phone ran out of space, so I had to put the video over in the computer and start again. So, and then the first one that I did over here, I could see that you could actually not see my hand properly, so I decided to do it over. But you haven't missed anything, because again, it's just the same thing that we do again and again over here. So I will just do a few more rows then here together with you guys to make sure that you are okay with it. So one orange on into the single bead, orange into the purple single, turning, and one purple into the single one, one more purple. So the single one, oops, there we go, and ouch, sorry guys, I just poked my thumb on the needle, sorry guys, I hope I didn't scare you guys too much. Sorry, but going to take the orange one. And now the thread is teasing me. Eesh. And then another orange into the purple one, switching color again, purple, and the last purple. So I'll try to put it up here so you guys can see it much better. So we started here in that seed bead. So go into that one. And then up in the first one. And again, this is what you're doing every single round, and then pull the thread, because we want it to be tight, very tight. And this is what you're going to do all the way up to the top. I think I will take one more row together with you guys. So, into the single seed bead. One more. The same color into the purple. Color two times. I'm sorry guys if you can hear my breathing and my sniffing, but my allergy is not that good today, so and affect my breathing a little bit, so I'm sorry if you can hear that I'm breathing a little bit heavy. So, here we go. And one more. Last two purple. Go on the last one. Into the first one where we started. I hope you guys can see it. And then up in the first one. And then pull tightly. So that is what we're going to do all the way up until we don't have more thread. And I will show you guys what we're going to do when we are out of thread. So I will just pause and I will come back when I don't have more thread and show you what to do then. See you in a bit, guys. Okay, now I'm back again. And as you can see, I don't have much thread left. So now I want to secure this thread and take a new one. So, but what I'm going to do is, to start with, I'm just going to take a few beads of the new round, because then I can see where I started and where to go again, because that's just what I like to do. So here we go, just a few, because then you can see where you ended. So what you're going to do now to secure this thread is simply just go through the beads, down and round and into the beads. That's how you secure the thread so it won't run up. So you simply just sew down in the beads. I will just take it down here, it's more easy for me to work with. So, I hope so far it have gone good for you guys. and that it haven't been too difficult to do. Also when you do this down the drill in the beads, it will also help to make it more tight with the beads. So in all, it's just a win-win. And again, you decide how far you will go down on the pen. To be honest, already now it is enough. There will not be any chance for the fret to come out in any way. So yep, I think that will be enough. So now we just cut it off. Just cut it off as close to the beads. There we go. And then we take a new thread. I can see I don't need that much left on it, so I won't take that much. But I actually noticed something with this one, and if I put the other one here to the side that I have made, you can actually see the one that I'm working on now is actually not that long. So yeah, oh well, it's okay. I actually thought that all the drill pens had the same length, but I can see now that they don't, so yeah. But it's okay. So here we're back again with the new thread. So let's see where we ended. We ended there. So we wanted to make sure that we come up in that piece. So you can see we ended in this one. So if you follow around, you can see the row it is in, and then we just start somewhere on the drill pen and take the thread up again to where we ended. I won't take the thread totally out right now, but I will do that in a second so it actually disappears, so we won't see it. Oops, yeah, that's a drop. I pulled too hard. But it's okay. There we go. And then you just go all the way up to where, oops, I knew it. I'll just go down again. Oops, let's see. There we go. There. I'll just let the thread be longer then. So I don't do that again. Also because you can just cut it off when you're done. So, but it's all up to you. To be honest, I'm actually loving this one. Also because the stripes are a little bit bigger. I don't know what your opinion is about the one that I have made and then this one. So yeah, it's all up to you how you want to make it. If you want to make it like the first one I did, or like this one where the stripes are a little bit bigger. I actually think that I like this one more, since the stripes are bigger. So yeah, I don't know. I like the first one too. So, but after this one, I'm going to try something else and actually try and make one where it looks like there are little flowers on it. So, but that will be an experiment, and if I succeed to do that one, I will definitely show you guys how it ended up, and also if I'm satisfied with it. Otherwise, maybe I will just tear it apart and don't show it. If I'm not happy, I'm just like, if I'm not happy with something I make, then I just start over again. So yeah. So here we are up in the tub. So now you see I have a little bit here hanging, so you can just cut it off, because the line is secure now. It's not going anywhere. Also because we want to do so we can pull the thread, because we want the work to be tight on this one. So, oops, the purple one. So, but again, just the single ones to the one that we started with. And up in the first one. And again, as I said earlier, if there is anybody that have any question about this, or I'm not sure, I will answer all questions about it, and also if anybody need it, I'm willing to take a talk over Messenger to help you out if there is anything. Also because, to be honest, when I'm sitting with something like this and trying to make these videos, I do get a little bit nervous. I don't know why, but I just does, and then I start to say some words wrong, and that freaked me out a little bit too, and immediately when I say a word wrong, I just know it, and I'm just like inside of myself, oh no, you did it again. So yeah, and it's just funny, because when I'm sitting and talking with people directly, I'm fine with it, and then I don't do any mistakes. But once I'm sitting here behind the camera and doing this, I don't know, I simply just get nervous in some way, and starting to mess up some of the words. But I definitely hope that you guys do understand what I'm saying, and I haven't and that I haven't messed up too many words. And if I have, I'm so sorry. But again, just make a comment. Write to me if there is anything that you are unsure about with this one. As I said, I will gladly help, because that's just how I am. If anybody need help, I will be there. So, but again, of course, again, we have to think about the time. Also, because I'm from Denmark, so we have to think about the time different. But right now, for me, when I'm sitting here, it's actually morning time. I actually wanted to finish this last night, but it just got too dark, and finally we have started to get some rain over here. So I'm happy, but it just make it a little bit more dark outside. But that's okay. But I think I will pause the video here and come back when I'm at the top of the drill pen, because it does take some time to do this beading. So I will see you in a bit. So I reached the top and I put the drill, multi-drill pin in, the tip in to the drill pen. And again, you can decide if you want to put the free or the nylon. So it's all up to you, or if you don't want to put any on, it's totally up to you. So right now I'm just going to make a few rounds here, because I don't want to let any of the drill pin show. So we're just making one or two. I think I will do two rounds here. It's definitely not that easy with the big one on, but it's okay. There we go. Oops. But I must say, I definitely have fun to sit and do this. And again, you can use whatever color you want. So it's all up to you to decide what color of beads, seed beads you want to use. So pull it good, and then I will take one more round. And I really love the thickness of the pen when you're done with this, so it's not so thin to hold to. So yeah. Oops. One more purple. has 2 ones. Yay! Insert the last one. So, and tidy up. Let's see. Yeah, I'm satisfied with this. So, what I'm doing now is, since I have this long thread on it, I'm just going all the way down to the end. No, I actually think I want to go through the last round here. Yeah, that I want to do. I actually think I did that on the other one too. I can't remember, to be honest. And again, I don't have any recipe for this. It's again, it's just something that I had in my head and wanted to try. So yeah. Want to poke myself again with the needle. It does hurt when you poke yourself. So, and now I will go all the way down. And again, also when you do this, it actually help to make it more tight also. Oops. But yeah, it does take some time to get down in the other end. But I definitely hope that you guys have enjoyed sitting and watching this, and I hope you guys will try and make some, and I will be so happy to see some pictures if you make any. And or otherwise just tell me how it went for you. So but yeah, it does take some time to go down in the other end because there is many beads to go through. But I think I will pause here and then come back when I'm down in the end. So be right back. Okay, so I'm nearly at the bottom now. So, but what you can see here is like it's missing one bead. So what I did, it was stopping here at where this color goes up, where this thread is coming out. So now I just go into this one instead of turning around. And of course my thread have to trouble. I don't. Oops. What is up with this thread? Can I get that away? What is going on here now? This one out. Come on, stop teasing me. It's typical when you want to show something, then the thread of course have to make trouble. So here we go. And then we go up in these. I think I need to do this a little bit. Then I'm just taking a single seed bead and then going into that one and into the next one. There we go, because that would stop the hole, but I want to get the beads a little bit down on the pen here, so we take one and skip one over here. Skip one. And jump over. Always when you do this, think about that you're going to jump one. So, but you can easily see here which one are pointing up to go into. So here we are going in to this one. Into the next one, going up, and pull all that you can, and then I will make one more round, my hands are in the correct place so you guys can see properly, because I can't do this over again. And then it's that one and up. So now what I'm going to do is actually skipping some. I will go into the first one. Then go into two and up. Take one into that seed bead, going through two again here, taking one that one, and then going up, and the last one, insert this one, and then up in the next two, and up in the first one we did. Yeah, it actually did. Let's check what it did here. I actually think my thread, yeah, I did. Just happened there. Oops, my needle bended. I think I have to go need some thread here to see what happened. One bead and into that one and pull, and one, and a single one, and the last one. Oh yeah, and of course my phone ran out of space. Typical. I can't wait to get a bigger SD card in my phone so I don't have this trouble, because it is a little bit annoying. But yeah, as you can see now, we are at the end. So what I'm going to do now is just going through the last row here. Just to make it a little bit more tight. Oops. You will see a little bit of thread down here between the beads, but that's okay. And now it's time to secure the thread. And that's just how we did the other times. It's simply just going around and around and around. Of course the thread is teasing me again. I must admit it's not that easy to sit and do when you are, when, also, well, now I'm what I would say was that it's not that easy to sit and actually do this, because again the camera is in front of me, so I can't have the project uptight or actually close to me, so yeah, but it's okay. Don't like how my needle is now. Why did I bend it? I just like to go up a good amount on the pen, because again, it does make it more tight. So yeah. And don't worry, because the thread or the beadings will not start to go apart, because you have secured your thread up so long on the pen, so there will be no trouble. So let's cut this one, and I think I will take another needle. There we go. Yeah, and then the last thread. Give me a new one. Okay. Where did I do to my tweezer? I don't know. I think it maybe is over by the computer. Ow. They're definitely stuck in here. There, I got one. So, last thread, and then we are done. So now we're going to secure this one. Now we're nearly done, and then we have a new beautiful drill pen. I think I will just take a few more rows up here, and then I'm done. There we go. And then cut the thread. Close up to the beads. There we go. And we're done. So now we have a beautiful drill pen. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope it was easy enough to make. So I would like if you guys would drop some comment on what you're thinking. And if you like the video, give it a thumb up, and subscribe to my channel if you like seeing what I'm doing. New subscribers are always welcome, so Here you have the drill pins that I made so far, I have made so far. So one with just one bead, so it's just a single row that turns around, and here with some bigger stripes. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I hope to hear and see some pictures. So I hope you guys will make some too, because they definitely is they just feel so good to have in your hand, because it's thicker now to hold on to. So yeah, but that was it, guys. So have a great day, and happy painting day, and I will see you soon again. Bye.